Hi there, and welcome to a Scratch tutorial. In this video, we will tackle the challenge of adding up and down looking to our clone-based 3D engine. By the end of the last episode, we had a pretty robust 3D engine. However, if we want to turn this into a full game, there are definitely some features that we will need to add. One of the most requested additions to this engine is the ability to look up and down, or more technically, camera rotation about the x-axis. While there are many successful 3D Scratch games that do not have this functionality, for example my 2016 game War of Droids, having it can help your game stand out from the rest. Sometimes it is even necessary for games where the player must move vertically. To add this to our engine, we will first set up the controls in the camera sprite. Since we will have more than one direction variable, we will specify which axis each variable is referring to. Since the y-axis extends upward, turning left and right is called rotation about the y-axis. Thus, we will rename our current direction variable camera y-direction. Next, we need to add a new variable for the up and down turning. This type of turning rotates the camera about the x-axis, so we will call the new variable camera x-direction, which will be for all sprites. Now we can start coding. First, we'll initialize camera X direction at the beginning of the script. Next, we'll use the up and down arrow keys to change camera X direction. Since the up and down arrow keys also currently control movement, we'll change those inputs to W and S. We can also add sidestepping with A and D. Having the arrow keys control turning and the W, A, S, and D keys control movement is a standard control scheme. With that done, the camera sprite is ready to go. Now, if you remember the previous episode, we coded a rotation matrix for rotation about the y-axis. We'll use the same technique here for rotation about the x-axis. First, we'll make a new variable, rotated y, for this sprite only. This will go along with the rotated X and rotated Z variables that we already have. Next, we'll make a new rotation matrix custom block like the one we already have, but for Y and Z inputs. For this script, we'll copy the code from the other rotation matrix, but swap out the X variables for Y variables. Finally, we'll add the block to our When I Receive Frame script. Now, the 3D projection block will take rotated X, Y, and Z inputs. If we run the project, we can see that the scripting works, and we can now look up and down. Now, you may have noticed that it can be a little hard to keep a sense of direction here. By adding a horizon, we can add a lot more depth to our 3D world. To do this, we'll make a new sprite and call it Horizon. First, we need to draw the costume, aligning the horizon with the center of the sprite. Now that the costume is done, we can start coding. When the project is first run, the horizon sprite should be behind all the other sprites, so we'll put when green flag clicked, go to back layer. Next, we want the sprite to update every frame, so we'll use the when I receive frame block. Now, the Y position for the horizon should be obtained using similar scripts to the object sprite. This consistency will keep our 3D world looking like a cohesive whole. We'll borrow the GoTo block from the 3D projection script. The horizon sprite should always be aligned horizontally in the middle of the screen, so we'll set the X to 0. We'll replace Y with sine of 0 minus camera X direction, and Z with cosine of 0 minus camera X direction. If you have experience with trigonometry, you may remember that sine divided by cosine equals tangent, so we can swap out the blocks accordingly. Now when we test it, we have a working horizon that is almost done. The last thing we need is to add code to prevent the player from looking too high or low. When this happens, the Horizon sprite goes off the screen. By adding some if blocks to the main script in the camera sprite, we can check to see if the camera X direction is too high or low, and if it is, we can set it to the appropriate value. The maximum value will be different depending on the size of your Horizon sprite, but here 50 degrees works well. Now, you may think we're done with the code for looking up and down, and we almost are. However, there is still one visual flaw that we have to correct. To see this more clearly, we have to start building some structures with this engine. In most of my clone-based 3D games, the wall panel is the fundamental component from which structures are built. I've imported this one from one of my games. We'll use it to build some towers. To do this, we'll make a custom block. This script will add a tower with a square base of 4 panels and a height of 3 panels. Let's add 4 towers to the world. When we run the project, we find 4 pretty respectable towers. However, if we look up, the upper levels of the towers shift in an odd way. This is because the wall panels should be tilted inward to account for the fact that the player is looking up. See, objects should point towards a point in 3D space that is directly above the player's head. This way, the objects point straight up when the player is looking straight forward, and the objects point inward when the player is looking straight up. Since this is how sight works in real life, this is how it should work in our engine. The question becomes, then, how do we find the on-screen coordinates of this point directly above the camera? And once we find it, how do we point towards it? In most cases, the point is far above the top of the screen. However, if the camera tilts up, the point comes closer to the screen. Technically, this point is defined as the point at which the y-axis crosses the plane of the screen. With this information, we can set up a right triangle between the camera and the point. Now, let's fill in what we know. The bottom angle of the triangle is equivalent to camera x direction, and the length of the top edge is equivalent to the distance to screen variable, which we set at 300 in the previous episode. The left side of the triangle is equal to the point's y position, which is the value we are looking for. To solve for it, we'll use some trigonometry. Tangent is equal to opposite over adjacent, which in this case means that the tangent of camera x direction equals distance to screen divided by point y. Next, we'll solve for point y. Distance to screen over distance to screen over point y simplifies to point y, which means that distance to screen over tangent of camera x direction also equals point y. Now we have an expression to find the y position of the point. Now comes the second part of the question. How do we point an object towards these coordinates? We'll use a relatively simple direction equation. Here we can put in our variables to make inverse tangent of point x minus object screen x over point y minus object screen y. Finally, we can swap out point x and y for our expressions from earlier, giving us inverse tangent of 0 minus object screen x over distance to screen divided by tangent of camera x direction minus object screen y. This is the expression we will use in our code. To simplify our code, we will create two new variables, screen x and screen y, which will be for this sprite only. To use these, we'll rearrange the code a bit. Now we can build the script to point the object in the right direction. And there we are! We have successfully added camera rotation about the x-axis to our engine. Thanks for watching! We will definitely cover topics like player physics and collision detection in later videos, and if there are any other topics you want covered in this series, be sure to let me know in the comments. If you enjoyed this video, please like and subscribe, and I hope to see you in the next one.